So hello again. So in this video I am going to talk about what is synchronous speed. So this is the speed of the rotating magnetic field that is being set up in the stator. So if you recall in the previous video, we had just seen that a stator having three phase winding and which is fed from a three phase source will create a rotating magnetic field. And it is as if that there is some kind of a large imaginary north pole and south pole, and the north pole is rotating this way and south pole is rotating this way. Now what is the speed of this rotation? Okay, so the unit that we measure speed in rotation is revolutions per minute. So in 1 minute, how many revolutions are these poles making? So that is a question we want to answer, and the answer is actually quite famous equation, which is 120 f by p. So ns is the synchronous speed in revolutions per minute, 120 is a constant, f is the frequency in hertz, and this is the frequency of the three phase supply, and p is the number of poles, and this number of poles is determined by the type of the winding that we are having. So but then this is the formula, so let's quickly derive it, how this formula is coming into picture. Now if you go back and refer to my previous video, here I was saying for every 2 milliseconds the air gap flux is rotating by 60 degrees, or proportionally like 5 milliseconds to 6, 6 to 7, every 1 millisecond the air gap flux is rotating by 30 degrees. And then if I look at the three phase currents themselves, now you notice that every 1 millisecond actually represents 30 degrees. So the speed of rotation of the magnetic poles is nothing but exactly that of the speed of rotation of your three phase supply. In other words, if I cover one cycle of my AC supply, in that one cycle of AC supply the magnetic fields are rotating by 360 degrees. But then there is a another conceptual point that is left here. We are assuming that the magnetic field is the number of poles for the winding is wound to be two poles. Okay, so let me draw that figure here. So consider this as the stator wound for two poles. So somewhere there will be a north pole and other place there will be a south pole, and then the north pole and south pole are rotating at ns, synchronous speed. So the north pole is sending out the flux and the flux lines are reaching the south pole, and the arrows will be from right to left, and then this magnetic field is rotating at the speed of synchronous speed. This is in the case of two poles. Now how will be the case if there are four poles? So this is north pole, this is south, this is again north, and this is south. Okay, so in one cycle of the supply it will not complete one full revolution. What happens is the north pole will go up to here and further go up to here. By the time, let's say this is n1, this n1 s1 n2 s2, so this n1 will rotate up to n2 and n2 will rotate up to n1. So it is only half a revolution in one cycle because of the same phenomenon that I have explained, because of the physical location and all these things. If you repeat this for the four pole machine, you will find it makes only half revolution. Okay, so let me write it. So two pole winding, one cycle of supply results in one revolution of magnetic or air gap flux. So if it is a four pole machine, then one cycle will result in half revolution, or I will write two cycles are required for one revolution. If it is a six pole machine, obviously three cycles will be required to achieve one revolution, and so on. So what is the factor here? If there are p poles, then p by 2 cycles will represent one revolution of air gap flux. Okay, now what is the time for one cycle? So if f is the frequency, so f is in hertz, sorry for the writing, f is hertz. Okay, what is hertz? One cycle per second is called 1 hertz. Okay, so p by 2, so I am interested in taking how much time does one revolution take. Okay, so one revolution is equal to p by 2 cycles, which is equal to p by 2 into time for one cycle. Okay, so the time for one cycle is nothing but capital T, which is the time period. Okay, or I can say p by 2 into 1 by f, because time period is nothing but 1 by frequency. Okay, so how much time does one revolution take is this one. So one revolution is this many seconds. Okay, so I ask how much time, how many revolutions will happen in 60 seconds. Okay, so this is one, for one revolution this many seconds are required. Or let me ask another question, what is the time for one revolution? So it is nothing but inverse of this. I can write it 2f by p is time taken for one revolution. Okay, so how many revolutions occur in 60 seconds? So simply multiply it by 60, so we get 120 f by p revolutions per minute. So this is our RPM. This is denoted as ns. Okay, so that is the derivation. This is a very famous formula. Ns is 120 f by p, is as important as the Ohm's law. This is the speed of the synchronous, the magnetic field of the synchronous machine, that is 120 f by p. Okay, we'll see more in the further videos.